Okay, so we've got the Lancaster starting 11 here. So number one, Jordan Taku Manawa White. Number two, Will Towler. Number three, Isaac Barlow. Number four, Ben Batterson. Number five, Freddie Palmer-Jones. Number six, Robin Lones. Number seven, Joe Munns. Number eight, Henry Horn. And now for the Lancaster backs. At number nine is Adam Fimister. Number 10 and captain, Jack Reynolds. Number 11, Pierre Jack Edelman. Number 12, Francis Satnaya. Number 13, Rob Cook. Number 14, Jake Fawcett. And number 15, Ben Lockton. There are seven subs for Lancaster. Peter, do you want to read the York starting 11? 15 even.
My pleasure. The York forwards, number one, Morehouse. Number two, Van Carr. Number three, Atkinson. Number four, Jimney. Number five, Russell. Number six, Newland. And number seven, Longmuir. And number eight, one of the co-captains, Lomax. And moving on to the other half of the York team, fellow co-captain number nine, Charles. Number 10, Ashdown. Number 11, Asimakopoulos. Number 12, Story. Number 13, ironically, Lancaster. Number 14, Purvis. Number 15, Totti. Again, seven subs. For York, we will let you know if any changes are made.
And two teams are just assembling now for the game. Lancaster will have the kickoff to start with. It's the final game of Roses 2022. We just had a really good women's game earlier. Let's see if the men's game can follow suit. Peter, are you looking forward to it?
I am thoroughly looking forward to it. Obviously, Lancaster have already won Roses, but we should be in for an absolute treat of a rugby match to round off this year's Roses.
And we're underway here. Good deep kick from Lancaster, but it's York who managed to get the ball away, and Lancaster will look to build again.
Great running from Lancaster, which is laid off, and he's gone down. York win the ball back. A penalty to York has been called.
Yeah, it looks like Lancaster have got the penalty.
Lancaster
they will
with another deep kick.
They will kick for touch here.
Yeah, as you say, kick for touch.
Gained a good 20 yards, and he'll have this line out on the left-hand side, just to the left of the York dugout. Good start for Lancaster.
Definitely. They've put York under some early pressure with some good deep kicks. This line out needs to be won by them, though, if they're going to make this pressure count, you think. Great leap and layoff by Lancaster to get the ball moving once again. Big tackle from York, however. Laid off, Lancaster running again, but York's defence is standing strong. Penalty. I think the last competition that I could find certainly information for was Bucks in 2019, where York reached the final and came runners-up. Lancaster, however, only reaching the quarterfinals, having finished third in their group. So hopefully Lancaster can come back from that disappointment. It has been 3 years. There will be a whole new group of players.
Absolutely, yeah. It's the first Roses since 2019, as has been well documented. Penalty there on York's number seven, Longmuir, and Lancaster kick for touch again. They've got a line out here on the right-hand side. It's going to be thrown in by Towler.
It's
knocked on, and it'll be a scrum to York. We saw in the women's game earlier the kind of handling was quite difficult. It was very wet conditions, especially in the first half. That definitely had an effect on the handling from a York point of view. It's a little bit drier now. It's not raining, but the ground will be fairly moist, shall we say, so the ball will get wet. We're interested to see how that affects the handling of the players. York will have a scrum now. It will be Charles will put the ball in. We are just 2 minutes in now. It is still pointless between Lancaster and York here at Roses 2022.
On the subject of that Bucks round in 2019, Lancaster did play in the tier above York this season in 2022, but they are set to join York in tier two next year after finishing bottom of the league with just one league win all season. Two of their losses were close of the nine, as they secured losing bonus points in a 19-24 loss to Liverpool and a 16-17 loss to Manchester. York finished fourth of six teams in their league, winning four games and losing six.
So it should be a fairly even game as Charles puts the ball in the scrum again for York. He gets it out the other side, bowls it out to Ashdown. Ashdown looking to build here for York. Tackle comes in. Charles picks it up. Looks like he's going to go left and does. Tackle comes in from a red shirt again. York on the third phase now. Charles goes left towards Lomax, his fellow co-captain. Tackle comes in again from Lancaster. Go right this time. York just under build.
Another big tackle.
That was a big tackle, Peter. You're right. There. But York get the penalty.
Will they kick it into touch? They are quite deep in their own half of the pitch, though. So they've got to try and push further up with this kick.
This is a good... you're right, Peter. It's a good opportunity to gain a little bit of ground here. York, under pressure, but the handling was pretty slick there. They did good five or so phases, and now they'll be able to kick for touch with Charles. Can he find touch? No, he can't. Lancaster do keep it in, so York didn't fully make the most of that penalty, but they have gained some ground. Lancaster trying to build out here.
Running there from the Lancaster number 15, Ben Lawton, to try and regain some possession as Lancaster push back with a deep kick into York's half, which will be mopped up, you think.
Yeah, good kick. It is well mopped up
by Totty of York, who can run forward and is tackled. And York can recycle possession now.
Well caught by Ashdown. Good slick play from York there as they go from left to right.
Really nice passing from York. They've worked it across to the right wing, and Purvis is tackled by the Lancaster defence, and it's gone out to touch.
Yeah, good move from York there. They got it left to right very quickly, but a good tackle comes in. It will be a line out. Good crowd is built here. We saw very good turnout for the women's game as well, which is really nice to see. But you know, really good crowd here as well. It should be pretty rowdy late in the afternoon. Rugby union, obviously, one of the showcase sports of the Roses. Lancaster with the line out on their left hand side. Towler throws the ball. It's a deep one. They will now build to the right hand side.
Roses 2019.
Penalty to York.
Roses 2019 was a very interesting encounter. York won an incredibly close game, 24-23. But as we say, this is a whole new group of players. The last time York won at Lancaster was in 2016 in a very low scoring affair. 8-6 was the score last time York won away.
We saw it in the women's game as well, 12-10 to Lancaster. That was a very low scoring game, very close, entertaining. Well, hopefully we'll see a few more on the points here. Looks like they might try and kick here.
Charles to kick.
Charles, the kicking tee is out. It's just fair way out. It's an ambitious effort. He's going to go
for
it.
He's gone for it.
And it is.
And it's gone through.
It's good. Excellent kick. And Yorker on the board. It's 3-0. A really good kick there, obviously fairly straight, but you know, some distance out, so he's done well to get it through.
Charles scores the first point of the match with 33 minutes left in this half. Very little of the game has gone, and it's still anyone's game. Both teams have been very solid defensively, managing the counter-attacks of the opposition, and a lot of line-outs, lots of people kicking into touch, trying to gain some ground in this match.
Yeah, Charles did well there under pressure. It was a good box kick. And Lancaster will have the line out. As the drizzle just starts to come down here in the northwest of England. Always makes for entertaining rugby. Towler, it's a deep line out again. It's claimed by Henry Horn of Lancaster. The maul comes in.
Incredibly well fought maul, very even. Didn't really go anywhere. And Lancaster will retain possession as they try and work the ball from left to right. Deep kick picked up by York. And York can run back again. Number 12 getting three there. Lovely layoff to Totti.
Really well fought exchange there. Charles picks up the ball again. They have two behind. Who is tackled. York will look to build through the phases as they did a few minutes ago, culminating in that penalty kick. Charles out to Ashdown. That's been a good combination so far, the number 9 and 10 for York working well together, as is always good in a
again rugby team. From left to right, but Lancaster defending quite high up the pitch, and the kick forward is going to be collected by Lancaster, who again kick it forward deep into York half.
Yeah, I think with the rain coming down, I think we may see a few more kicks, with the handling becoming increasingly difficult. They both want to test the opposition back line, opposition fullbacks, their ability to catch high ball, which, you know, always tricky in wet conditions, as we saw in the women's game earlier today. Sets of players just take the opportunity to reset, take on some fluids. Looks like York kicking here is again Charles, who had success earlier with that right boot of his, is going for a going for it again.
It's a lot more difficult, and the kick is quite flat into the hands of Lancaster, who can look to counter here. But the ball is fumbled and nearly goes out to touch. But they hold on to it well.
Yeah, and I think you're right. It's always an ambitious effort from there. You know, it's quite a flat kick, but it did, you know, get York up the field. Lancaster put them under pressure, put their handling, and York are, you know, they're very far up the field now, right?
Absolutely.
Always right outside the try and putting that Lancaster defence under a lot of pressure. Lancaster will have to put in from this scrum, but their kicking game's going to have to be clean in order for them to clear the lines. We'll have Finister will put the ball in here for the hosts.
Just over 10 minutes gone. York, no points on the board since that wonderful kick from Charles in the early stages of this match. York still 3-0 up as Lancaster try and work the ball from side to side to try and break through this York high defensive line. As you say, kicking is going to be very important as the conditions worsen.
Lancaster do kick there right on key, Peter. It's a tough catch that for Totti, and he does fumble, but York do have possession, and Purvis will kick towards Lancaster's left-hand side. It will be picked up by Lawton.
The dead ball line for Lancaster to regain possession.
Yeah, and like you say, it was interesting there. Your first real time. What's his name? Totti's been tested under that high ball. He did recover well after dropping it, and York were able to build again. So he did well. Lancaster will have the ball outside their dead ball line now, as they look to clear the lines. It was well held there by Ashdown for York. Lays it off to Lomax. A penalty to Lancaster. They're very happy with that one. Maybe in at the side there, can't quite see what the referee was signalling in his sky blue shirt. Penalty for Lancaster.
Lancaster kick it to touch, and it will be yet another line out.
A few yards to Lancaster there. As the umbrellas shoot up, in the crowd.
Atmosphere hasn't been dampened by the rain, though.
Yeah, very
both,
true.
Both sets of fans very much up for this, even though York have nothing to play for, having already lost Roses. They will play for pride, though, and they are playing a very, very good game so far.
Obviously, you can't help what goes on in other sports, so you just want to do the best in your individual sport, really. And
very much so, and they are doing very well. Lancaster have had very few opportunities in the first 14 minutes of this game.
They're looking to build here, though, into their into the third phase. Tackle comes in. York's defensive line, as you say, Peter, very good so far. And Lancaster looking to build down the right hand side, but the pass was slightly off there,
and too far behind, and it goes out to touch again.
Edmonton couldn't do much about it. It was just behind him. So York will have a line out on the halfway line. Having said that, I think the referee's looks like
back.
He's pulled it back. Yeah.
Penalty to like Lancaster.
Lancaster will get the chance to level the scores. It's just to the right of the goal.
But similar range to Charles's kick earlier in this match.
It was, I think just slightly to the right of the posts, and it's definitely kickable. And Lancaster have an opportunity to
level the scores. Lining up. And it's through. Lancaster equalise with another strong kick.
And it is 3-3 here, 15 minutes into the game. Two penalties have been the point contributors so far. Two very good kicks. It is 3 points apiece as York will resume proceedings with Charles.
Kicked deep, and Lancaster will regain possession as one of the backs does slip as he kicks it, but it still goes out to touch. I think we'll see a fair few more mishaps and slips from both teams as the rain does come down.
Yeah, York will have a York will actually have a line out on the left now as the Lancaster kicked. The kick from Lancaster came in and just went out of play, so Van Can will put the ball in for the visitors. The line out is turned over, though. Good work from Lancaster, but will York get possession back? The referee blows his whistle. See what he's signalling here. I think York have got the scrum from what he's looking to signal. That was as the home crowd getting good voice, getting behind their team as the red shirts of Lancaster and the black and gold of York assemble for the scrum, which Charles will put into the scrummage.
You have to say that the converted penalty for Lancaster has given the crowd a bit more belief as the time ticks down into the middle stages of this half.
Yeah, always good to get your first points on the board. It gets the crowd going. Charles puts the ball into the scrum for York. He does get it back, but the referee blows his whistle. Lancaster seem pretty happy with that. Will the referee look to just reset the scrum? He's walking between the two sets of forwards now, just letting them know what he expects, as is his right to do. There we go. Second attempt now for the scrum. We did see a minute ago the first turnover from a line out of the game so far. And it was York were the ones who lost out on it, so they'll be hoping that is not a regular theme in this game, as Charles puts the ball into the scrum here. Gets it back. Solid scrum from York, but Charles drops the ball.
Ball is dropped, and Lancaster have possession again.
Some
good strength from the Lancaster man to advance the play into York's half.
Yeah, Horn did really well there, and Lancaster looking to build again to try and take the lead just into the York half at the moment. They look to move down the left-hand side. A grubber kick comes on the ground. He's going to test the York fullback who initially fumbled, and he is tackled. The Lancaster fans very much like that one, as Tosti is tackled well by the onrushing home players.
And the whistle is blown. Lancaster did really well to advance up towards the try line that York have been defending so well throughout the match so far. Some good pressure from Lancaster to try.
Yeah, it's the best moment of the game. Definitely, they've got a really good line now, about 10 yards out. It's going to be one that York's defence is going to be good. The Lancaster crowd in this corner near side very much got into that one. Trying to see how many men. Looks like a five-man line-out for Lancaster. It is caught by Freddie Palmer-Jones, and the maul comes in. Lancaster ever closer to the York line. It's held up well there by the defence.
Lancaster trying to force a way through now, but the York defence, as you say, is very strong. Kicked forward, but that will be mopped up by York.
Yeah, Charles as well. It's a good idea, little grubber kick along the ground, but Charles did well. He anticipated it. It's always just a foot race. Who's going to get there first? But the York man just had the advantage there, the skipper, and he will be able to relieve the pressure. As Lancaster man receives a little bit of medical attention. Both sets of players will take on board some fluids as we are just coming up to halfway through the first half. It is three apiece here, fairly even game, would you say, Peter?
I would definitely say it's a fairly even game. Both teams have had their moments working up and down the pitch. Both defences have been very strong. There haven't been any real sort of tense moments for either team in front of their own try lines. And it's been a very... very defensively solid game. Both teams have mopped up any advances from individual players as well as teams very well. No player of either side has managed to create something, a moment of individual brilliance, as both defences have been very good, as we say, as the ball goes out to touch there.
Yeah, I think you're right. That moment just there, where he was about 10 yards out, he went for a little bomb along the ground, but that was probably the closest they've come either side, really, as Charles relieves the pressure. We have a Lancaster line-out. It's by the... looks like he's about by the 22. On this right-hand side, just in front of us. As we are stood by the corner. Big line out this for Lancaster. It looks like it's going to be a seven man. It's caught well by Eddie Quimbleton. As the ball is snapped to the left. And it's held up by Lancaster. Go again. Tackle comes in.
Some good forceful running from Lancaster. York able to deal with it so far as the ball works its way into the centre of the pitch. This is right. Really Lancaster with a really good chance. It's laid off. and York get back into their shape.
Yeah, really nice move that from Lancaster. Really few good snap passes straight out to the right hand side, but I don't think the rest of the Lancaster team could quite keep up with it. But they could be in here again if they can switch it right. They can.
Laid off. Lancaster really, really close, but the York defence is still strong, and they win the penalty. Some really good movement through the phases there for Lancaster. Got really close, but again, York defence just doing well to soak up the pressure. And
absolutely, yeah. So Rex pulled it back for a penalty to the home side. Very much in kicking range. The kicking tee is deployed. I think we'd be very surprised if he missed this. Really good play from Lancaster. The first time we've really seen, you know, some really good combination passes really close to the try line. York defended it well, but Lancaster got the opportunity to double their lead. Double their score here, sorry. It comes in, it's high, and it scores.
It scored 6-3 to Lancaster. Just over halfway through this first half, Lancaster take the lead for the first time in the game with another penalty being converted.
Yeah, I think that probably sums up the last few minutes. I'd say I think Lancaster have the last 5 or 10 minutes, they have been the better side since we last reflected on it, and there's a good few nice plays there. They've been gently knocking on the door and they've been able to turn their advantage into points.
Absolutely, as the ball is kicked deep back to York.
Totti does well. He watched the ball and he looks at 18 yards of his own. He is tackled.
Totti's, in my opinion, has been York's best player so far. He's been very solid at mopping up those deep kicks and has driven with some really nice, in a really nice direct way at that Lancaster. Yeah,
I think whether like the conditions we've got today are a fullback's worst nightmare. It's just, you know, it's such a pressure position. You know, the ball's in the air, especially when you're away from home. The crowd get on your back. It's a lot of pressure, and I think you're right to mention it. That he has withstood it well so far. I think Charles and Ashdown have combined really well. You always want that scrum half fly half relationship, and that's been pretty good so far.
It has been very strong.
Any standouts from a Lancaster perspective so far, other than obviously the kicker who's got 2 kicks for 2 so far?
Well, I don't think, in my mind, there has been a real standout for Lancaster, but I think it's just they've worked really well as a team to advance play, and then when York do have the ball, they've defended very well and defended as a team. No real standout. They've made the most of their penalties, certainly, but they've just been... It's a very good team performance from Lancaster so far.
York have the advantage here, but the ball is lost and the referee will bring it back for a penalty. So the rain just continues to pour here with just a quarter of an hour left in this first half. Here is the final Roses fixture. It's Lancaster 6, York 3. Lancaster, as you mentioned earlier, already claimed the Roses crown for this year, but Rugby still highly anticipated fixture in the Roses calendar, and as such it has drawn a good crowd here today, as York will have kicked for the line out, which will be on the right hand side just to the left of the scoreboard as we look at it, and Van Cam will put the ball in for York. They look like from here they're going to go for a five man line out. The ball goes left.
Another good direct driving run at that Lancaster line, and a fumble from York, which gives Lancaster a chance to regain the ball, which they have taken.
Yeah, Lancaster have obviously made the turnover, and they're looking to build a few phases together of their own. Currently held up in a ruck and just inside the Lancaster half. The ball is out and the kick is in. Good box kick there, and it's going to be a chance for
nervous to collect. He's going to have a run. He's well tackled. The crowd appreciate that. It comes in for York. Van Kan looking to make some ground now here. He is tackled. Ball goes out to Ashdown. Looks left. It's dropped and it will be brought back for a penalty to the visitors.
You'd have to think it was a bit too far out to consider kicking it.
Yeah, I do. I think you'd have to have a missile on the right foot.
Absolutely.
So I think he'll just take the line out a few yards up the pitch. We saw in the women's game, York looked a quick tap quite a few times because I think they lost their kicker just before the warm-up. Charles can't find touch there, and so the penalty advantage is lost. But I think
Charles picks it up again, though. Can he drive at that Lancaster line? Tackled well. Crowd appreciate that.
Yeah, I think we saw in the women's game, York lost their kicker just before the game, so they didn't have much. They didn't really use the kicking game that much, so that meant they couldn't make the most of their penalties. And in a close game, that obviously could be the difference. But Charles has been pretty good for York so far, though he'd be disappointed not to find touch on that occasion. But Purvis looking to build down the right hand side. His kick is charged down, and York will get it again on the right hand side. Trying to see, has it gone out of. Has it gone play? Looks like it has, and it will be a line out. Van Campbell be able to exercise that his throw again. Or maybe not. I think Charles will have a. Trying to see.
Called back for offside.
Yeah, good spot.
As the kick goes out to touch. Once again, no team has made any real mistakes from their line-out so far. Even in these wet conditions, both teams have kept possession well from the line-outs. The catches have been strong, and you'd like to see that trend continue, really.
Yeah, Van Kan trots over again to exercise his throwing muscles. Looking like a five-man for York here.
Ball goes deep again.
Just about kept in black and white hands. As York look to take advantage of that. He did well. Long make. It looked like he'd lost it, but he managed to recover possession. York will look to build through the phases in the deep into Lancaster territory now.
York trying to make something happen here as the ball moves to the left-hand side of the pitch. But the mistakes from both teams there as Lancaster can capitalise.
York could be in here.
And some good
just
defending,
about tackled out of play.
Forcing the York man out.
Yeah, no, I think you're right. It was a couple of mistakes there because it looked like an opportunity was there for Lancaster to intercept it. But unfortunately for them, they couldn't, and that let. And that kind of let York in down the left-hand side. It was a good run from Asim Akopoulos, number 11 for York. He nearly made it in, but it was a good tackle. The referee is looks like he's bought it back for a penalty. As Charles does have the ball in his hand, waiting to decide what to do. It's a bit to the right of the post, so interesting to see what he does do here. Looks like he's called for a scrum. It's a single figure minutes left for this first half. 6 points to three for the hosts at the moment.
Lancaster looking to finish Roses off strong as the scrum prepares. Midway into the Lancaster half, York trying to put the pressure on and score the first try of the game. The ball goes in, and it's excellent work from the York scrum to maintain possession as the ball moves from right to left. Good tackling again from Lancaster, however. Nice passing from York. Can really nice move.
Yes, they can.
And the try is scored for York. That's excellent running and excellent passing from York as they moved from the scrum all the way to Lancaster's try line.
Fantastic move. And as you, and, you're saying, ironically, in the build-up to the game, number 13 for York, James Lancaster, he looked like he was the one who touched it down. Really good move from the visitors. They went right to left, really swift passing, and then the reverse pass back inside. I thought they'd have gone to Asimatopoulos down the left, but no, they went back in. A little opening there for Lancaster, and he really took advantage to put York in their 86 at the moment. The conversion opportunity here, it is to the left of the goalpost, but you'd assume Charles would really fancy his chances here.
And can he increase the visitors' lead as Rob Cook has scored the first try of the game? York's number 13. Charles to take this kick.
And that is
and
good.
And he converts. And the lead increases to 10-6 to York.
A good conversion under pressure. Obviously the crowd try to put him off on that side, but he's done well so far, Charles. He's 2-for-3 on the kicking. And I think the third one was quite far out, so I don't really think we can count it, but he's done very well there, and York are 10-6 now. Really good try, as we were just saying before, the conversion is there. How important could that be in the course of the game? Lancaster still within a try and taking the lead. It is very close, but in terms of the first major blow of the game, Peter, you'd have to say that was probably it.
That was definitely it. The first try of the game is always an important one, and Cook and Fomister make the most of it as the ball is fumbled by York and kicked deep to Lancaster.
It was very, very much a knock on that. Could hide that in any way?
No, not at all.
Not quite what you wanted. You just got the try. Just want to calm everything down. Unlucky from behind. You know, tough conditions. It just spilled in and out. And unfortunately, the payment went straight forward. So no way the referee could miss that. And Lancaster got a scrum in a very attacking position here. You know, trying to strike right back on York.
Just been informed we've got the wrong try score. It was actually Lancaster of York that scored the try rather than Cook, who I said before. But even so, it's still an important one.
Yeah, as you said, the build-up is like ironic. There's a person called Lancaster playing for York, and he's even more ironic that he scored the try.
Yeah, we've just got our lineups modelled, I'm afraid, but it's the nature of the beast, really. As Lancaster fumble possession and York have it again as the ruck goes over and York get possession back. A great kick from Fomister deep into the Lancaster backs.
Yeah, Charles's kick was well charged down there by the Lancaster defence, and they can build again.
Again, direct running right at that York back line. As Lancaster look to move through the phases, the ball is kicked forward, but very good defensive work from York there.
Yeah, so Longmire did really well just to throw his hands on that ball, because otherwise Lancaster would have had an opportunity down the left-hand side. As it is, he's done a really good job for his team. And there will be a scrum on that far side right by the technical area. 5 minutes to go in this first half. It's Lancaster 6, York 10.
And scrum is called for and knock on. As York look to maintain a bit of composure after that Lancaster pressure, as there are less than 5 minutes left of this first half, with the lead only 4 points. As you say, there's still a try could turn the tide of this game for Lancaster, but York have won the ball from the scrum as it is kicked clear.
Yeah, Ashton did well. Lancaster appealing for a knock on though, the Lancaster supporters, but Ashton did get the ball before it hit the ground, and Lancaster will build again on halfway. The tackle comes in to build through the phase. There's quite a few quite a lot of phases were built up early in the game. Lancaster have the penalty. yellow. Is that a yellow card as well? Yeah. Not sure. I think I saw some yellow there. I'm not quite sure what was going on there. Yeah, York's number seven has made his way off. Shinden would like to get some confirmation on that if possible, but looking like York may well be down to 14 here. As it was a young man who just done some good defensive work earlier. He's currently making his way behind the technical area, so Lancaster just before the end of the first half when the start.
And that's the first mistake from a line-out we've seen. But Lancaster have done well to regroup and win the ball back as the ruck comes over and Lancaster win the ball.
Yeah, good from Lancaster turning over the line-out, so they've got a real opportunity now. Can they finish this half? They finish strong. They look to get it out to the left. As a tackle sort of comes in. It does come in now.
Lancaster doing very well on their left-hand side to try and get closer to that try that could turn the tide of the game. The Lancaster coach is furious on the sidelines as one of the dugouts has been broken by one of the York players.
So you understand why, because they have to pay for a new one. Not what you like to see, but scrum here on the left. Put in for York. Is it? Hard to see from here. It is. The referee just having a word with the players, letting them know. As the crowd on that side where the scrum's been taken getting increasingly boisterous.
Minute and a half left of this first half. York still holding that 4-point lead. Still a very even game, though, wouldn't you say?
I'd agree. I think it's been fairly even. I think York could just turn their advantage into a try, but Lancaster have done well here. But York have won a penalty. Probably did a penalty shooters for collapsing the scrum there. I'm not quite sure. The scrum did seem to turn round, and Charles will gratefully clear his lines, because just before the half-time break, York a man down at the moment, by the looks of things. So they'll be definitely wanting to get to half-time with the scores as they are. As you say, Pete, it's been an even half, I say, so far, so York will definitely take their 4-point advantage.
As the time ticks down into 30 seconds left, York look to go into the half 10-6 up with another line out to try and just hold on to possession in these final moments. The line out is deep and Lancaster win it back.
Another turnover, the line out from Lancaster.
But you don't think they'll have enough time to make it count. Oh, a mistake from York, and Lancaster score a try right at the end of the half. That was very, very sloppy, you have to say, from the York back.
Oh, absolutely.
Ball bouncing. It is difficult in these conditions, as we say, but that has cost them as Lancaster make the most of it. Score now 11 to Lancaster and 10 to York.
Yeah, it'll be so frustrating there, York, because obviously, first of all, they lost the ball from the line out, which is not ideal, but you feel you could become the grubber kick came in, always testing that York defence. And it was just going to be a foot race. The York player got there first, but kind of miskicked it, and that allowed Lancaster to make their way in the scrum half for Lancaster with the try. They will have their conversion. It's a tough conversion.
Feimster with the try. It's a tough conversion.
And Feimster there, as you say, right on the
right place,
on
right
the ball.
Time.
Exactly that.
As the conversion wide of the post.
Just wide.
Just dips over. An excellent kick. Just about got it right. Wide of the posts. But the lead, 3 points going into the half for Lancaster.
Good kick. I thought it was going wide, but he did manage to place it perfectly. And that is it for the half. A dramatic end to the first half. In a fairly even contest. One try apiece. And just Lancaster with that extra penalty is why they have the 13-10 advantage. Fairly even half. York looked like they were going to be closing it out. They did go down to 14 just before the end, but it was a really dramatic end to the first half with a bit of York. A little bit of sloppiness perhaps, and Lancaster took full advantage, and that's why the scores are as they are.
So we move into half time, a slender advantage for Lancaster. Who do you think has been the best player for each team?
I think it's a very good question. I think Feimster with that try right at the end there looks like it's one of the decisive moments of the first half. Anticipated it really well. Yes, there was a mistake from a York point of view, but really good play from Feimster. Lancaster's kicking game has been really good as well. I think both sides have been fairly solid in their kicking as well, which we may see in the second half become even more crucial in these wet conditions. A fairly even half, but it is Lancaster who just about shaved it with that extra penalty, and that's why they're going in a 13-10. Peter, what did you make of that first half?
Well, I thought it was a very even match, you have to say, and I think the two scrum halves, Charles and Feimster, have both had excellent games so far, making the most of both mistakes and their own ability as well, and the fullbacks as well have had very good games. It is very difficult for them to try and control the ball from those long, deep kicks, but they both have made minimal errors and have been just generally very good at advancing play for both teams. I think second half is going to be very interesting, however, and it's anyone's game. It really is.
Absolutely anyone's game. I think we talked about this a little bit on commentary in the first half, but the Lancaster seem to have worked out the York lineouts quite a lot. There were a lot of turnovers, I think two or three in a row lineout turnovers towards the end of that first half. The last one obviously culminating in the try. That might be something York want to look at in the second half in terms of changing it. But do you think any side needs to change it that much or kind of keep it as it is?
Well, I think, as you say, that if Lancaster have figured out the York lineouts, they certainly will have to change something in that regard because they don't want to be turning over possession from their own lineout. But in general, with sort of defensive shape and formation, I think both teams are very solid. There have been very few opportunities, both tries resulting from a couple of errors from either side, and I think in that regard they don't really need to change much generally. But as I say, lineouts for York are probably something that they want to change, if you are correct and Lancaster have them figured out.
Yeah, absolutely, and obviously a lot of support here, big crowds here today. Being the first Roses in 3 years, obviously, and the rugby season's been fairly, this season probably been the first one for a while because of the pandemic and things. So big crowds here today. So what I'm getting at is, how much of an impact do you think the crowds had on the game? We saw some fairly boisterous Lancastrian support in that first half, especially down on that far corner just behind us where the try was scored. How much of an impact do you think that's had on both sides?
Well, I think the crowd certainly has helped the Lancaster team with not letting their belief in them and the noise that they create has not allowed Lancastrian heads to drop all that much. And I think that support is part of the reason why mistakes have been made by York, I think, throughout the game, especially at the end.
Thanks very much, Peter and Joe. Guys, are you going to be all right? We've got Patrick O'Donnell, and I don't think I know your name. What's your name? Oliver Robinson, who are the Students' Union presidents for both York and Lancaster, for you to have a chat with.
Oh, fantastic. Here's O.
Are we on now?
Yes. We are, yes. We are live, so I'll start with you, Patrick, because my York bias, I'll get to you first. So what did you make of that first half?
It was fantastic. I mean, the weather is absolutely miserable, isn't it? But I think, you know, the York boys did an absolutely brilliant job. I used to play rugby a long, long time ago. But they've got some really, really fast guys. They're getting a try, and they're doing well.
And dare I ask you for a score prediction for full-time?
What are we now? 13-10. To Lancaster. I think we're going to win. It's going to be a close match, but I think you're just going to get there.
That's fantastic. Patrick, thank you very much.
And sorry, I don't know your name, Ivan. Oliver, nice to meet you. Thank you very much. Yeah, it is my first year here, first roses, and we are... It's been 3 years. How much do you think that has affected the support here?
Oh, well, I was nervous, but I think it's absolutely brilliant to see that people have come out. They've remembered what Roses is, and, you know, there are alumni here, there are people of all ages and all creeds, and we've all come together to support Lancaster, because, after all, Roses are red.
They are indeed. And score prediction for full-time?
Oh, I wouldn't dare go so far, but we're definitely going to win.
Wonderful to hear from you. Thank you very much.
Half-time interviews there, myself and Peter, with some important student union people here today showing their support for Roses. And we're underway for the second half. York kicking towards us left to right as you watch it on the TV. Lancaster kicking towards the car park end. York have kicked it off for the second half, so Lancaster will have possession and will look to build here. The rain has... stops Peter, which is pretty nice.
Tackling.
York have won a scrum there, if I can get my words out. You mentioned visibility, and as a glasses wearer, rain is a bit of a bugbear for me, I'll be honest. But so York have got a scrum on the 22. As we look at now, right in front of us. Big thanks to Patrick and Oliver for doing the interviews with us at half time. Much appreciated. And no substitutions for either side as well. We've had that. Confirmed, but York still, I think, about 7 minutes left with that man disadvantage. So, well, they're in the and it was Longmire, the number seven, the flanker, who was the one who was simping. So, we're gonna have to bit of a makeshift scrum here for York, but Charles will have the put in here.
Lancaster win it back, and it is going to be retaken.
Yeah, it looked like Lancaster overturned it there, but the referee clearly not happy with something, so he's just going to lay down the law. Signals the redo there.
York with some early pressure, however. They have moved quite far into Lancaster's half, near the 22.
Charles will put it again.
The York crowd showing some support. As Lancaster have done very well there to overturn possession with a really nice scrum from their forwards.
It certainly was. I mean, the last scrum, they upset the York line there, and obviously they had to retake it. But that one, they won the penalty, and they were able to get ground at the pitch, as we touched on just before. One of York's flankers, Longmire, not on the pitch currently. So it's going to be a bit of a makeshift job for York and Lancaster, taking advantage that they've got the line out, which Towler can put in on the left-hand side on halfway. Line out. He's overturned. York get it. He's very well there.
Can they make the most of it, though, as the ball is kicked down this left-hand side with the Lancaster with some very nice direct running there. Good tackling from York, though, as well.
Lancaster with possession here. Lowndes with it, drives and is tackled. Well, they will go again with Fyminster with the box kick. Very scrappy start to the second half, I think. Both sides battling for possession. York come out on top of it, but there is a knock-on. But the referee goes back for a penalty to the visitors.
Penalty kicks out to touch for another line-out.
Into the crowd, so we'll be in line out just before the 22 by the looks of things. So this is a promising position here for York. Van Can will put the ball in into the line outs. York going for the five man.
Trying to not make an error this time, as it was that error from the line out that cost them right at the end of that first half, caused Lancaster to score their try.
And it looks like York are using their substitutes here as a couple of fresh pairs of legs and clean shirts come on, which is always how you can tell in rugby there's been a sub. And Van Can will not put the ball in. He is being taken off by the manager. He'll be replaced by Boothby, whose first act will be to put the grid to the box. And it looks like we'll get confirmation of the other substitutes when we receive it.
Hopefully soon. As the ball is fumbled and knocked on by York. Playing advantage, however. And
yeah, just getting confirmation out of that substitution. It is Van Can off and Boothby on.
Lancaster still with no substitutions, but you get the feeling that as the game wears on, and they will make some, as they will need to freshen to try and hold this advantage should it stand late into this game.
We saw in the women's game, Lancaster made good use of their bench. They rotated quite well. Their number 21 who came on did a really good job of stopping York's attacks down the left. Whereas the Lancaster men so far have not used the bench yet. What they have got here is a penalty just inside their own 22 in the central position. They'll be able to clear the lines. Siren goes off for Longmire. He's back on, so York are back to the full 15.
Appears to be a siren in the crowd. It's quite entertaining, really.
Absolutely. People are enjoying themselves.
It's what it's all about.
Indeed, exactly that. First time for 3 years, and I know we've spoke about that all the... All the sports you'll have heard over the weekend will have mentioned it's probably been the first rose in 3 years. And it is very true. And I think games like this where you get your big crowd, it really does kind of does bring it home to you. It's great to have this sort of stuff back and everyone able to enjoy themselves as looks like Lancaster will have a scrum here as their number 10. Jack Reynolds and the skipper looks to try and rally his troops, two arms aloft in the air, trying to get them going. Scrum here for the team in red and black. Will be put in by Fyminster. His try is why Lancaster are leading at the moment. He's got every point so far for Lancaster, so he's doing well today.
Having a very good game, as are most of the Lancaster forwards, to be fair, with some really nice running from one of them there.
Yeah, Fyminster there again. Right on cue. Good run, made a lot of ground. Lancaster in a dangerous position here as they whip it right to left, but it is knocked on.
And York have the ball again, looking for some direct running at that Lancaster defence, and a penalty is called. Lots of Lancaster players warming up on the touchline that we can see from here. You get the feeling that some rotation will freshen things, as this has been quite a scrappy start to the second half, as you say, and maybe some fresh legs will create a more free-flowing half of rugby.
Dangerous position for Lancaster here, as Towler will put the ball in for a line out. Lancaster, are they going for a... Looks like they're going for a seven-man here. So looking to open up that space on the right-hand side for the back, for a straight contest between the backs. They do win the line out, and it is a maul.
And the try scored. The maul driven forward towards the York try line, and the Lancaster forwards a bit too strong for them, just forced back, and the ball is bundled over the line for another try.
Really good maul there. Really good set piece from Lancaster. The line-out worked really well. It was a clean catch, and it was a really good maul. That's probably why they went for the seven-man, because you know you're able to get that extra power in with the forwards, and they did, as you say, Pete. They overpowered that York defence. Was a really good try. It's down the far end. We'll get confirmation of who scored it in a sec, but chance for a conversion. Jack Reynolds is on it. It's quite far left, but. He should back himself here.
Robin Lowndes was the try scorer as the conversion comes in. And it's through again, wide of the post, but another good kick for Lancaster as they increase their lead to 10 points now with 10 minutes gone in this second half.
Yeah, absolutely. Lancaster starting the second half as they ended the first. Good solid kick there from Jack Rails, the skipper. And York will have to do something now. They're going to need at least two tries to get back in the lead here. The kick is long. It's well held by Fyminster.
Who kicks forward again.
Sati has it now for York.
Long pass across the pitch. The ball is long again, and another good catch. Lancaster looking to run at that York defence. Really good running from Lancaster.
Oh, and Jack Reynolds really a bit of showboating there, you know, shimmying left and right. York do have the penalty, do have the ball. They will pick, and it looks like it will go safely behind the net. Safety behind the dead ball line, not troubling the Lancaster defence.
And we'd like to say again, if you can hear the crowd at home and do take offence to any of the language, we'd like to apologise, but there really is nothing we can do.
Scrum here. And halfway as the referee brings it back for that penalty. York look to kick forward. There's an ambitious move, which you can when you do have the advantage. So, Lancaster have the scrum. Has to go 5 minutes with the put in.
As the ball enters the scrum. It's a nice quick scrum from Lancaster. The ball is fed through really nicely. And as the ball moves over to their right hand side.
Yeah, good play from Lancaster again. 5 minutes to go left and right, and penalty. And the referee just waited to see if he wanted to take the advantage there. But for it looks like possibly an offside, but Bowman says we'll happily take it back.
There have been some substitutions during right at the end of that play. We'll just get confirmation of that now.
Yes, the kick is taken, and it'll be a line on the left hand side. So, yeah, it looks like it's going to be Charles going off for York, and number 15, Totti as well. Oh. Lancaster line out is taken and won. They will look to build again a bit further out from where they got their last try from, so they will look to move left to right. Lancaster doing a good job of that. And
some really quick passing to try and move the York defence across the pitch and move through the phases themselves as the ball is recycled.
Building through the phases here, the home side. Looking to add to their 10-point advantage, sorry. As Lancaster's number 8, Henry Horn, makes good ground and is tackled. Fireminster goes right. Tackle comes in. Lancaster recycle possession again. Goes to the right. Jack Reynolds. Tackle comes in again. Advantage is played. No, it's not. It's brought back for a penalty. Right between the goalposts. Around where the 22 is. So plenty of options here for Lancaster. I think they're going to take the 3. Probably a sensible decision given the lead they've got. They should do just to stretch it even more. No need to risk going for the 5.
Absolutely not, no. They have the 10-point advantage with a chance to extend that to 13 as the sun is trying its hardest to peek through the clouds as conditions are improving. And the kick about to be taken, as you say, right in the centre of the pitch, right in front of the goalposts.
Reynolds
should be bread and butter and a fairly confidently taken kick. Lancaster have very much started this second half on the front foot, and it's shown in the scores.
Yeah, they've definitely been the better side, I think, as the game settled down into its pattern. They obviously have played higher level rugby this season. I know they were relegated, but you can probably see that little bit of a difference has probably started to show a little bit as York will get going again. Charles with the kick.
Taken deep, and Lancaster trying to advance play once again. Extend their lead still further.
Horn will drive here. He's done well. Horn and using that energy, that 13-point advantage, you're going to have a lot more energy as Reynolds will kick.
Kick deep.
It's well caught there by the York man on the left-hand side.
And York kick it long again. And it's fumbled by the Lancaster back, but it's still...
Yeah, Reynolds did well there. He initially dropped it, but did go backwards, so he's able to kick. Kick touch, line out for York. York look like they're readying some more substitutes. So we'll get confirmation of who those are in a sec.
Lancaster have made 2 changes. And we are just getting confirmation of them now. as the line out comes in. It's taken deep and York win the ball back as they look to move forward towards Lancaster and put them under some pressure now.
So Ben Batson is on for Lancaster, as is as is Peter Murdoch.
Good running from Charles there to advance the play. York Ruck, good protection there as they look to move through the phases, try and get a try back.
Right to go right left. This is a really good move, and he's struck right at the end. York still had it though. He went backwards, did it? No, the referee is giving the scrum to Lancaster. It's probably York's best move of the half, but the pass was an awkward one. He had to catch it around shoulder height. Always difficult under such pressure in front of the more rowdy section of the crowd there as well. Pressure's on, and Lancaster do have that scrum. Scrum for Lancaster, put in by Fireminster very shortly. We are just ticking up to the three-quarter mark of this game here. 23-10 to Lancaster. They built up a sizable lead. They've scored 10 points in this half. That try, conversion, and the penalty just a few minutes ago.
Lancaster are being put under quite a lot of pressure, but the kick clear into touch is good and allows Lancaster to regroup and try and hold on to this advantage.
Yeah, again, a few yards out, line out for York. I think York also seems to have made a switch of their own. Shaw is on for York here, number 20. As the line out is going to be taken here by Boothby. The aforementioned Shaw jumps, misses it. It was over everyone, and Lancaster win it back here with Reynolds. Reynolds towards Fireminster, who kicks.
Fireminster kicks long, and it's caught again by the York fullback. Charles this time, good running from him to try and make something happen for York as they move the ball towards their right wing. Really nice passing from York.
Can he offload it?
He's still driving. Some excellent work from York there to try and advance play, which they've done really well. Can they break through and try and make a game of this?
Yeah, massive moment in the game here. It was a good run from Lancaster, number 13 for York. They are really close to the line now, into the fourth phase. 5 yards out. It's gone left. Charles here.
Really nice drive from Charles. As the chance is still there for York.
Shaw with it. Shaw's over the line.
The referee, I think. For a penalty.
Penalty to York.
Five yards out.
Penalty. You've got to think they'll go for the five. I mean, I could be wrong. I often am. But we'll see what goes on. I think Charles has called for the scrum here.
We are into the final quarter of this match. 21 minutes gone, 19 remain. Lancaster still holding their 13-point lead, but York, with this scrum, have a really good chance to eke into that and really put pressure on Lancaster.
Charles is not putting this one in. He's hanging back. Wise move in case there's an opportunity for a drop goal. I think that's probably the thinking here for York, if it does come to that.
The scrum goes in. And it's laid off. Nice passing from York. Charles done really well.
Surely got to get over.
He's dropped it. And the try stands. Does it?
I think it's a scrum to Lancaster. I think he's knocked it on.
Knock on right at the end of that move. It was really, really nice passing from York. And it's just... the ball will be wet. The conditions will have a major role to play in that, I'm sure.
Oh, I agree with that, Peter. What, and the pressure as well. But what a chance that was.
That was an incredible chance.
I thought there was no way it was not going to be a try, but credit to Lancaster's defence.
the atmosphere as well. They are attacking where most of the Lancaster noise is coming from and will make the pressure, as you say, is quite large.
Leinster with the, as the with ball the is knocked in, on I think through the scrum. Advantage to York is there. York do get the scrum, I think. It's going to be a turnover. Good spot, Peter. And York are going to have the scrum right where the Lancaster scrum was, right in front of us, 5 yards out on the right-hand side.
Again, another really good chance. York really need to make this pressure pay now.
Absolutely. You're very correct on that one. They missed a golden opportunity. That last chance, it was for York, I think it was Ashdown, just missed the drop for the try. They put in here for York. Massive put in. It is Warren who put the ball in. He's got it again. It's held up. Drive comes in from Boothby. He's held up. Shaw getting in there now. Lancaster holding up again. It's Palmer Jones. Ashdown just couldn't get it over. I think Lomax was the one before. He's over that left now. And the Lancaster crowd like that one. It's played by Lancaster. And that is a try. And it's Warren who's over. Warren is over for the visitors. This should be an easy conversion as well. So York get the deficit back to within five. And if Charles goes to plan, it should be. No, they've got it back to within eight. If Charles goes to plan, they'll get it to within six. And York's pressure did eventually pay off there.
They didn't lose heart. They kept driving at Lancaster's defence, and they've scored a very good try from sustained pressure there. And it's game on now, especially with the conversion from Charles. The lead, as you say, now 6 points with 15 minutes to go in the game.
Lancaster 23, York 17. Last quarter of an hour here. York are within a try and a conversion. That should give them hope. It was a really big moment in the game. They did make the pressure count. It was that the scrum on this side after Ashdown knocked it on, Lancaster got the scrum, but York were able to turn it over. That was a really good scrummage from them, and that's what created the opportunity. And it was Warren who got the ball right up against the spongy bit at the bottom of the post. So that was good enough for York's second try of proceedings here, as Reynolds kicks off for Lancaster. As well. It's well caught there by Shaw. And York will look to build again, look to keep that momentum.
Nice passing from them as they work it towards their left-hand side. Chance to run at Lancaster now as the ball is laid off once again. A really powerful running from York, showing their strength, showing their fight now.
And they get the penalty. I think it was not moving away. Signal there from the referee. I'm ready to stand corrected on that if so. But either way, it is a penalty to the team in black and gold.
Penalty due to the ball not being released as he went down, and the ball is kicked deep towards the Lancaster backs, who catch it well. Fireminster kicking long and out into touch. As the time ticks away, Lancaster looking to hold on and end Roses off strongly with a win in arguably the largest event of the weekend. It certainly attracted the largest crowd I've seen.
Yeah, I'd agree with that. I think the big crowd here. American football was pretty big on Friday, but I don't think it's got anything on this. Do apologise if you did hear any language here, as Lancasterian fans exchanging a bit of banter with York's number three. York do have the line-outs.
But yeah, the the fight that York are showing to try and work their way back into this game, especially with the try now. Their belief is sky high as they are soaking up this Lancaster pressure now right in the middle of the pitch.
Lancaster did turn over that line out, so another turnover for them. It would be interesting if we did have any stats on that, what the turnover percentage from lineouts was, as good tackle comes in there. Lancaster still have possession on halfway. The referee is signalled and the medics are on. Very good decision from the referee to stop the game there, as safety of the players always comes first.
Lancaster number three down after, I'd assume, a bit of a reducer of a tackle or a stray boot, but this is a very aggressive and injury. The injuries are common in rugby, and it's really nice to see that attention was brought to it. We don't want anyone hurt.
So both sets of players do take the opportunity to take on board some fluids and
discuss tactics,
some instructions. Exactly, yeah. As we are 12 minutes 23 to go. It's 23-17 to Lancaster. So what do you make of the second half so far? Lancaster started it the better, got that really nice try in from that maul, but York have come back with a try. It's 23-17. Now, what have you made of this second half so far?
It's been a very good second half. Lancaster, as you say, certainly did start it on the front foot and made the better of the early chances. But York have had the better of the game recently, especially with that try. They are showing they're not down and out, and it's still within a try and conversion for them to turn this deficit round. Still, anything could happen in the final 12 and a half minutes of this match, as a substitution has been made for Lancaster and York. Number 14 of York being substituted.
That sees Purvis's day on the right wing is done.
And
he is up.
It seems to be a head injury, however, and we just hope it's nothing too serious, as the replacement is for Lancaster is number 18.
Number 18, so Jean Felici will look to replace. Looks like Isaac Barlow going off there.
As we say, we
the
hope
Lancastrian it's... Lancastrian crowd, do confirm that for me. Yeah, I do hope he's all right. Good to take the necessary precautions there. And we will get the game restarted with a Lancaster scrum.
Lancaster scrum right on the middle of the pitch, as they look to move the ball from left to right with some neat, quick passing and a chance to run. Lancaster driving at a quite thin York line, but the tackle is good and it's knocked out of their hands as the ruck comes over and York look to regain possession of the ball.
Yeah, Murdoch and Kate Bread play some really good passes in there. Good combination between those two. It did slow down after that, allowing York to regain the ball. They kick for... the kick for safety. Lancaster will get it back now as they look to drive.
Good forceful running to try and advance play for Lancaster there. They're number 14, who has done really well to keep the ball under a lot of pressure from the York defence.
He did very well indeed.
Lancaster look to move through the phases. Nearly eat through. It's not really good chance for Lancaster to run at the try line, and it's gone. Lancaster score another try right on the 29th minute of the second half.
Jay Munns, the number seven, who's got the try, drove right through the middle, right underneath the goal posts. It's a cracking cracking try from Lancaster. It was a really good drive, as you say, from Fawcett a minute ago. That gained the ground and that created the opportunity for Lancaster to make further ground, and Joe Morsett picks the ball up centrally with an opening and he takes advantage fully. And you've got to say, it's surely game over now. 28-17 to Lancaster. We've seen stranger things happen, but Lancaster very much got 1.5 hands on this, you say, as Reynolds looks to bring up the 30-point mark with this conversion, which is level with the left-hand goalpost, so he should make it.
Should be nothing too unfortunate that happens, as it does go through right in the middle of the two posts, and the Lancaster lead back up to 13 points as we enter the 31st minute of the second half. Just under 10 minutes to go of the game and of Roses as a whole. Lancaster back in a commanding position.
Yeah, very commanding position, as you say, Peter. And the referee has signalled for a time off. I think the ball is being changed, maybe. Being returned. Charles is certainly asking for something. He seems happy now. Time is back on, and the kick is long. Well held by Jay Munns. He's just scored the try, and he's now passed it off to Murdoch.
The body feints coming out as Lancaster look to break through once again.
Indeed, Robin Lambs driving. Tackle comes in. Fireman still with it. He goes for the box kick. He's been good at those today. It's a high ball for the York Man to collect. Charles
has dropped it, but there wasn't significant pressure from Lancaster as he looks to drive through. Really commanding run from him.
He's done well, Charles. He did recover nicely. York has surely got to go for it now.
A neat little kick from York, but it's mopped up very nicely defensively by Lancaster as they regain possession right on the side of this, right in front of us here on the left side. Right on the sideline as the ball moves further centrally.
Penalty to Lancaster.
Taken quickly by Lancaster's number 9. Some fantastic running as the ball works its way to York's half. Really good running from Fyminster.
Absolutely, penalty was taken quickly. It was a good decision to take quickly. I think it caught York a little bit off guard there, and Lancaster pretty much made the entire length of the pitch, so a really strong position here. York do have the ball back. He went behind the dead ball line, so Charles will clear his lines. Under 8 minutes to go now. 30-17 is the score in the men's rugby union. Lancaster men looking to complete the rugby double today after their women won 12-10 in a very exciting low scoring game earlier today. It's Louds who's driving now. He is tackled. The ball looks like it'll go out to the right. When it's released, it does.
Quick passes to get Lancaster out on this right-hand side as a strong tackle comes in, and Lancaster look to move the ball back centrally as they try and break through the York defence.
And Lancaster get the penalty. In at the side, perhaps they are really stand corrected, but. Either way, penalty to Lancaster. The kicking tee is coming on.
Substitution from York has just come through. We've been notified that number 19 of York has come on the pitch to try and shake things up for the visitors and try and work our way back into the game.
That's Hind. Hind is on for York here, number 19. Very, you see, and they're very tall, just in the middle of the goal face. Lancaster going for the kick. It's just inside the York half for Reynolds, who I don't think he's missed one yet today. So he'll be looking to
fairly dead on as well.
Straight, some distance out, but yeah, relatively straight. He's back in though.
As the kick comes in.
And he has skewed it. I think that cursed him there.
It's gone wide to the left-hand side as we look at it, of the goalposts, and Lancaster didn't make the most of that. York to try and...
I think a bit of the commentator's curse there, I'd say. Given I said I thought he'd do it. But either way, York have possession here with Charles. There's just over 5 minutes to go. 30-17 the score still is, as Charles kicks it to his opposing skipper, Jack Reynolds, goes long. Charles has it again. Tackle comes in.
Still on his feet though, Charles, as he's advancing the play really nicely.
And York get the penalty. Looks like a not releasing there. Charles puts it out for a line out to York on the left hand side, right by the more rowdy section of the Lancaster support. We're just under 5 minutes to go here. That's 5 minutes of Roses 2022. Overall, as an event, first one for 3 years. As a Lancaster person yourself, would you say you've really enjoyed being a part of it?
I have definitely enjoyed being a part of it. I think the whole sort of vibe, as it were, around campus has been... It's vibrant, certainly, and I think it's been well recognised by everyone that's come and got involved with Roses. All the support has been very... It's what you want to see, really.
Yeah, absolutely, yes, absolutely. York do win the line out and about a couple of phases tackle each time. The build again. Just
off.
A foul keeping in. There is a problem when it goes backwards. Lancaster just looking to close this game out now with no dramas. York two tries away, really. So they've got to make something out of this spell of possession.
Their chance is getting ever narrower as we enter the final 4 minutes of this game.
Warren tackle. He's looked to bite Sparks. He's coming, obviously got the try for York. Drive comes in now. Again, tackle comes in. The drive was
good. Rucking from York there to maintain possession as the ball is finding itself ever wider and the ball is knocked on. Advantage being played for Lancaster as they regain possession and just look to see the game out now.
The advantage was Lancaster's four back knock on under pressure, and that probably just about means that will be that. Lancaster will have the scrum here just the other side of their 22. That's just under 3 minutes to go here today.
Just got word of some rather nasty allegations from our man in the dugout, Sam Randowich, with a complaint of racism. Apparently the number 19 of York has been racially abused. You really do not want to see that.
Absolutely
we do not,
not
condone that, and we hope security can sort it out.
Yeah, absolutely, and we hope that the victim is okay. And a penalty to Lancaster.
If the allegations are correct, it would put a rather sour note on what looks to be an ever more likely Lancaster victory to round out Roses.
Yeah, absolutely. We just hope that Hind is all right. Hope he's okay. As Lancaster do kick for their penalty, York do have possession back here. Tack comes in. York looks to build again here with Ashdown. Goes down. Charles with it. Out to Ashdown now. Ashdown looking to run. The referee does blow his whistle.
One minute 40 to go and 14 points in 1.5 minutes is quite a tall order for York to overcome. They've just Lancaster seeing the game out quite effectively now.
Absolutely, taking the time to get to the scrum as is their right to do. And they will have a scrum here. Can they adds to their add to their 30 points. Getting 30 points, always impressive. Their attack has been pretty good today. Obviously, when York went 10-6 up, it was looking pretty good for them when Lancaster, number 13 for York, got that try. With that 5 minutes to try, just the back end of the first half, that I think that was probably the key turning point in the game, would you say?
It's a fantastic time to score a try right at the end of the half. It's a very important. It shifts morale completely. Like, York will have been wanting to see that out and going into the half 10-6 up, but they will have been affected by that. And I think that's why when Lancaster came out firing in the second half on all cylinders, that might be partly due to just sort of York's morale being dampened slightly as they failed to see the lead out at the end of the half.
Lancaster do have another penalty here within kicking range for Jack Reynolds. He missed his last one, so he's off his 100% for today, but is this one to the left of the goalpost, but it's within kicking distance.
And this penalty will be the final action of the game, as the timer has ticked down to show zero remaining time. Lancaster have won the men's first rugby. Can the penalty kick put the icing on the cake for Lancaster?
Oh, it steps up. He's had a good game today. As Lancaster skipper, he should be very pleased with himself.
As that ball goes wide to the left as we look at it, but it won't matter. Lancaster have won the rugby, both matches here today. And that seals what has been a very, very good overall performance. York advance the play. Whistle still not blown.
York are playing on here. Perhaps because obviously the timer went off as the kick was being taken. So I guess still some time left to go. But this will be the last action of the game.
Some good defending from Lancaster. Nice quick passes from York to shift the play, but a good strong tackle that crowd are responding well to.
York looking to take something back with them on the M62 this evening. Bit of pride here perhaps, as Ashdown bowls the ball out wide. He continues to go right to left, tackle comes in. This will be the last play of the game now.
People in the Lancaster dugouts questioning why the game still continues, but the ball still hasn't gone out of touch, so play carries on. Nice long pass out to right.
Really good York.
Really nice running from this York. Nice pass, and the try is scored by York.
It's Warren again. It's his second try of the game.
Excellent work by him and by the number 10 of York to try and advance the play.
Yeah. Been very good today, Warren. It's his second try. Lancaster have struggled to handle his commitments. And he's got two tries. He can be very proud of his performance today.
Absolutely.
That Jamaican impact. And there will be a conversion. It is 30-22. Charles stepping up. He's only missed one kick today.
And it is converted.
It's been a nice time. But Lancaster win 30-24. And wild celebrations, Peter.
Absolutely. The fans are absolutely ecstatic with the result. Quite a significant pitch invasion. Flares have come out. That just shows the sort of the pride that Lancaster have and the support that has been consistent over this, as we say, first roses in 3 years.
It was good to see people enjoying themselves, and I think full credit to Lancaster. They have been, as a sporting university, have been the most the better team over the last three games, and I think they're probably just about the better side. So York played well, they by no means disgraced themselves at all. They had some very good flashes. Lancaster's try in the first half, playing outside centre, really nice. And Warren has had a really good second half as well, but it was Lancaster who won the day here, deservedly so. That 5 minutes to try, we touched on a couple of minutes ago, back into the first half, and second half, an excellent maul, and it was a Joe Mullins try, as well as some good kicking from Jack Reynolds, who's been very consistent today, that has overall made the difference, which means they win by a pretty significant margin here. I think it's 30-24, could be mistaken, and Peter, any final thoughts from you?
As you say, Joe, the York team can be very proud of themselves. They played very well, especially at the end of the second half there. When the game looked done, they kept fighting. They got the try right at the end of the game, and they can be very proud of their efforts, and as can all of the York squads. They've made it a very competitive Roses. They've had their ups and downs, but the rivalry has been very strong throughout the weekend, and we thoroughly look forward to next year, where hopefully their home crowd advantage can pay dividends, as it appears to have done with Lancaster
here. Yeah, absolutely. I think there is a big home advantage. I don't think that's the only reason why Lancaster have won. But obviously, you know, there's the travelling, there's early get ups, there's sleeping on the floor, which is you don't get much sleep doing that.
No, absolutely not.
There is obviously a home advantage, but I think take nothing away from the way Lancaster have gone about the last 3 days, and you know, rugby today, both women and men getting over the line, fully deserve the overall score. And I think credit to the organisation of the event as well. I've been first year myself. I've really enjoyed the first one, and as you alluded to just a second ago, really looking forward to next year.
Absolutely.
And it looks like we've got some reaction coming over.
Fantastic. It's fucking amazing. We've never had a year where we've not lost any games. It's fantastic. We've done amazing.
Yeah, the boys put in a real fucking shift there. Real good shift. Couldn't ask for any more. York brought a really good side out. We just played the conditions really well.
Played the conditions well.
We came out with a victory.
How much do you think that try right at the end of the first half made a difference in the game?
Fantastic. But it kept our heads going. I mean, it adds more pressure, really. We can't lose our heads and think we're going to win just after one try. So it was important to keep our heads on, and we did that perfectly. So it's fantastic, really.
Yeah, couldn't say it any better.
Yeah, that's good. Now, does that try, mentioned the try at the end of the first half, the start of the second half, that 7-mile line out, followed by a really good maul to drive over the line. Is that something you guys have worked on?
Yeah, something we've come up on, Freddie Palmer-Jones, our chairman, he came up with it. We worked on it at boot camp.
Special move in it, special secret move for the second half, and it paid off, and it worked fantastic.
Yeah.
Absolutely did, and many congratulations to you, and enjoy the celebrations.
Thank you very much, guys.
Cheers. Well done. Yeah, good Lancaster reaction there. Do apologise for any language that may have offended, but I'm sure you can imagine the passion of the game. See when we can go. Yeah. Are we good to go? Okay, so obviously not the result
you were hoping from a York Spectre today, but sure, but an excellent game, and how pleased you with, you know, the way the team played.
Yeah, I mean, like, it's been a process for all three squads. Like, threes represented themselves well after not really playing together all year. Twos did well to get the tie. For the ones, it's been a pleasure. Nice to come out, like, have an exciting game. The crowd makes extra difference. Like, the 16th man, the ref was good. Like, I think the boys really stuck at it. A couple of errors here and there, a couple of 50-50s, and it could have been a different result. A couple of kicks, maybe. But, like, it was a good game. Just disappointing not to get the result, really.
Yeah, no, fair enough. And I think our first try, York's first try, the one Lancaster, the... Okay, no worries. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. And that is us done here from Men's Rugby Firsts. Thank you so much for watching. I've been Joe.
I've been Peter. We have thoroughly enjoyed the continued coverage of Roses 2022. We look forward to next year, and we hope you've enjoyed our coverage of this event. And thank you very much.